This solar panel turned out to be better than I thought. If you need a handy solar panel to charge a 12-volt battery, this one gets the job done. It actually has a lot of what you need for a basic setup. Let's see what it can do and what you get.
Frakking Creations, showing you the good stuff.
I used this solar panel to power a dash cam and charge the car battery at the same time, and it worked quite well. But before I talk about that, let's see if the solar panel can output its rated 1.15 amps at full sunlight. I have this battery monitor connected to the vehicle's battery. This allows me to monitor how much power the solar panel is putting back into the battery. At full sunlight and outside the vehicle, I was able to get about 1.11 amps, pretty close to the rated 1.15 amps. It's only 40 milliamps off, not too bad. When inside the vehicle and behind this window, I was able to get about 0.66 amps. And when behind this tinted window, it was able to generate about 0.3 amps. And note how, as with any solar panel, the positioning matters. As I change the angle under the same sunlight, the power output changes. When you use any solar panel, it's best not to place it behind anything, even windows if possible. And positioning it to directly face the most sun will get you the most power output. For my setup, I already have this battery monitor connected to the vehicle's battery, and this ThinkWear dash cam is connected to it. With this setup, I can monitor how much power the dash cam is using from the battery. If I then connect a solar panel too, I can see if it's helping to power the dash cam so that less power is used up from the battery. On a sunny day, this solar panel was actually able to power the dash cam and charge the car battery. For 6 hours, between 10:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m, the dash cam was running fine while the battery had 1.8 amp hours put back into it. Good stuff. This is a pretty good solar panel that has a built-in charge controller to protect the battery when charging. This means it isn't supposed to damage the battery as the sunlight conditions change throughout the day. It even comes with all the connectors you need to use it. The OBD connector is a great option to have when you want to charge the car battery with the solar panel installed inside. This is because the OBD port is always connected to the battery even if the vehicle is turned off. So you just install the solar panel and plug it in to start charging. The kit also comes with a 12-volt outlet adapter plug as an alternative to the OBD port plug. Just note that in some vehicles, the 12-volt socket will disconnect when the vehicle is turned off. This would mean that the battery won't be charged. Also, note that some vehicles disconnect the 12-volt socket a few minutes after the vehicle is turned off, so check the owner's manual or test this before using. The last two connectors are standard alligator clips and ring terminal wires to connect directly to the car battery. The suction cups are not too bad. They work well, but make sure to store them in a way that doesn't bend them out of shape. When out of shape, they don't work well and need to be reshaped before they will work again. This FlexSolar 20-watt solar panel is quite well made and seems very sturdy. Pick one up if this suits your needs.